Hi everyone, this is Kalyan Kumar and welcome to another edition of Unboxing and Review in Product Review. In this video, I'll be unboxing and reviewing the Apple TV 4K. Before I do that, let me state this in the interest of full disclosure that I bought this product with my own funds and it is not a review product. All the opinions you're about to hear are my own. No one is paying for this review and no one is reviewing this video before it is uploaded. Secondly, if you wish to look at a specific aspect of the product, then I have put the timeline markers in the description below. If you're watching this on a computer, then directly click the timestamp, and on a mobile phone, drag the playhead to the approximate timestamp. The Apple TV 4K has been available since September 2017. It is not unusual for most people to hold off buying a new product until the dust settles and the reviews are in, but at some point you must make a decision on whether to go for it or skip it. If you're still considering buying the Apple TV 4K, here are some reasons to say yes and a few reasons you should say no. But I got it because of the Apple ecosystem, wherein every Apple device has some functionality and interaction with the other. For example, Apple AirPods can function very well with Apple TV. If the AirPods had been paired with an iOS device earlier using the same Apple ID, you can screencast the Mac or any iOS device to the Apple TV using AirPlay. You can use an iPhone to act as a remote for Apple TV. It is also possible to record the screen of Apple TV using a Mac if they are in the same Wi-Fi network. So if you're having one device, buying another will make more sense, provided of course you need it for some reason. So first let's get to the box, then do the unboxing of the Apple TV 4K, and then we'll go for the detailed review. So starting with examining the box. The box is basic and uncomplicated. The first thing you notice is the Apple TV image on the front of the box. It doesn't indicate which version it is. It is the sides that reveal that it is Apple TV 4K. The back tells you some of the services that will work. These services stream 4K HDR, and the ones that are not mentioned, including YouTube, do not support this format. The one that I have is the 64GB version, while a 32GB version is also available. Now this set me back by ₹18,000 approximately, which converted to the US dollars is 270, while in the US it is available for just around $170 to $180. The cool thing about this is that Apple TV supports Dolby Atmos, which is a 3D surround sound, as well as Dolby Vision, which is a version of the HDR. Now let's go for the unboxing. Let's cut open the plastic around the box. With the box open, you will find the Apple TV 4K on the left and the Siri remote to the right. Now let's take the beast out of the box. The Apple TV is very small. Unwrapping the Apple TV now. It is very slippery. This is the TV box. Then you have the starter guide. Then you have the lightning cable for charging the remote. Unwrapping the plastic around the remote. Now we'll take out the power cable for the Apple TV. There is a black plastic wrap around the sides of the TV box. Peeling it off. So this is what you get in the box. Next is design. The first thing you'll notice about the Apple TV 4K is its design. It is a good looking device. It follows the same overall look as the earlier Apple TV with this all black square shape, and it is quite small and compact too. The device comes with a footprint of 3.9 inches long, 3.9 inches wide and 1.4 inches in height. In other words, you will need some space for it on your TV stand, but it won't draw too much attention to itself. On the back, you will find a HDMI 2.0 port for hooking up to your 4K TV, along with a gigabit Ethernet port for a more stable, constant internet connection, especially if it is far away from the router. And you'll also need a power port. Missing though from the back is the USB Type-C port that was there on the earlier version of the TV. Apple says it was only meant for service and it is not needed anymore. Ethernet connection would be recommended, though not necessary always, for streaming 4K HDR content. But in my testing, I found the Wi-Fi connection to be pretty good. But for 4K HDR streaming, it is recommended to have a download speed of at least 25 megabits per second. Another major difference from its predecessor is the vent and fan at the bottom. This is because it is running hotter due to the latest A10X Fusion processor, the same used in the first gen iPad Pros. This processor, apart from processing 4K videos, is also involved in upscaling any video to 4K HDR. Once you set up the device, you'll not be interacting with the device, but with the remote. The Siri remote design is pretty much carried over with a trackpad towards the top and a smooth glassy surface at the bottom. To make the orientation clearer, we now have the raised white ring around the menu button. The top has the glass trackpad that has the physical click, and it is better than the previous version, which was a bit finicky. The device has a dual microphone on the front and back, though in India, this remote does not have Siri voice support. At the bottom, we have the lightning connector, which is symmetrically balanced with the IR blaster on top. Next is setting up the Apple TV. Connect the Apple TV with the high-speed HDMI cable to your 4K TV. Then connect the power cable to the Apple TV. And the other end to the AC main supply. Switch on the TV and navigate to the correct HDMI source. The first thing you will be greeted with is selecting the language. Swipe the remote on the trackpad to the language of your choice and click the trackpad. Now select your country or region. For PAL countries like India, it will ask you to switch to match the display format. Select it. If you see a clear picture, hit OK. In the next step, choose if you want to use Siri. As I said, in India, Siri won't work anyway, but I'm still going to hit Use Siri so that if and when it is enabled, I'll be able to use it later. Now you'll be asked to set up the Apple TV by using iPhone, iPad or iPod Touch or manually. I choose Setup with Device. The iOS device will show Apple TV and in that hit Setup. Follow the on-screen instructions and keep the device close to the Apple TV. It will then give you an authentication code on your television screen. which you need to type on your iOS device. Now the screen will show that the Apple TV is being set up. The next info to be set is whether you want the App Store to seek a password for any future purchases. I hit never require. Now the screen informs that Siri is not available in India. Hit continue. Now you have to choose whether you want to enable or disable location service. Now select whether you want the 4K HDR screensaver to be downloaded or not. Next, choose if you want to send the analytics of your app usage and location to Apple. Similar message with Apple developers. Now agree to the terms and conditions. And finally, the home screen opens up. Next is 4K HDR. For the most part, tvOS still looks like a slightly blown up version of the iOS home screen. Apple's tvOS platform hasn't changed much. But since tvOS 11, the company did add a new feature called One Home Screen, which lets you sync up your apps and the layout across multiple Apple TVs. As you can tell by the name, the big difference with this new box is 4K support, which offers 4 times as many pixels as 1080p HD. That makes it ideal for bringing out the very fine detail like individual strands of hair and blades of grass. Most people won't be able to see much of a difference with the jump to 4K from the normal viewing distance. You need to be sitting really close to a TV set of 55 inches or larger to truly notice it. Even if you have a massive TV though, you will notice the addition of HDR or high dynamic range video more than the 4K on its own. On compatible sets, HDR lets you see more intense brightness, deeper blacks, and a wider range of colors in between. On newer films, the difference can feel like night and day. That begs the question, how to set up HDR? Go to Settings, Video and Audio, and you will see the format and resolution options. To turn this feature, you need to know whether your TV supports it or not. And this is where the problem starts. There are two HDR standards that Apple TV supports, HDR10, which is more widely adopted, and Dolby Vision, which is visually superior. A TV that supports Dolby Vision would also support HDR10, but not vice versa. Apart from the HDR supporting TV, you also need a high-speed HDMI cable. Apple wisely chose to support both HDR10 and Dolby Vision. But in the typical Apple fashion, it's offering these new formats in a slightly different way. Unlike other devices like the Nvidia Shield, which enable HDR when you're watching the video that supports it, the Apple TV 4K always has HDR enabled. And this creates a problem by having a washed out UI. If I enable 4K HDR at 60, you will notice how faded and washed the UI looks. I've tried all brightness, contrast, and color adjustments, but this is what I get. And this is primarily because the Apple TV is upscaling the UI, which is normal HDR content, to 4K HDR, which creates the washed out interface. So the best setting is 4K HDR at 60fps, and change the setting based on the movie that you're watching. Make sure to switch on both options of match content, that is match dynamic range and match frame rate. This way the UI will appear bright and vibrant and the display will match the movie being played. Several apps including Netflix, Amazon Prime Video and iTunes support 4K HDR. If you have already bought movie titles with FHD in iTunes and 4K HDR is available for these movies, Apple automatically upgrades the movies to 4K HDR. For new movie titles, HD and 4K movies cost the same in the iTunes store. One big downer is that you can't get YouTube to stream 4K content to an Apple TV 4K. This is because YouTube is using the VP9 standard, which Apple does not support. The TV has the same gaming platform as the iOS. The TV remote can also be used for gaming as it has the accelerometer and can be used in a horizontal orientation. You can use the Apple TV remote on the iOS device by downloading it instead of the included remote. You can do so even by using an Apple Watch. Next is screen recording using Mac. Wireless screen recording of Apple TV is easy to set up. You need a Mac running High Sierra, and assuming they are connected to the same Wi-Fi network, all you have to do is to open QuickTime, open File, New Movie Recording, and click the arrow near the record button. You will see your Apple TV name listed there along with other cameras. You will need to authenticate using the code the Apple TV throws up, and the Apple TV screen is shown outlined in red. Next is the interface. The interface of the Apple TV hasn't changed much. The top row shows what each of the icons has when you highlight that particular icon. To move icons, go to any app, click the trackpad. Scroll using the trackpad, and wherever you want to drop the app, click the trackpad again. You can move an app on top of another app to create a folder. You can create as many folders as you want. Inside the folder, if you click on an icon and press play pause button, you get the option to move this app to the home screen, delete it, which means uninstalling the app, or move it to another folder. A long press of the menu button takes you back to the home screen, and a single press to the previous screen. If you press the home button key, you'll go to the Apple TV app first, and then another press will take you to the home screen. This is something that you can set. On double tapping the home screen, you see the multitasker from which you jump to different apps that are open, or swipe up to close the apps, just like in iOS. In video and audio, you can change your resolution to 4K HDR at 60Hz. Apple TV 4K supports Dolby Vision only at 30Hz. You can also select whether you want the Apple TV to match the dynamic range of frame rate or both of the content being shown. With 4K HDR, you have another option of chroma. This helps you to change the compression of luminance and color data. You can choose between 4:2:0 and 4:2:2 for 4K HDR, and 4:2:0 and 4:4:4 for 4K SDR, and it will reduce the compression and the picture looks clearer with high color vibrance. If you go to General and About, you can see the software details of the Apple TV. Under Appearance, we get a light mode, a dark mode, and automatic that kicks in based on the sunset and sunrise. Under Bluetooth, you will see your AirPods if you have one through your iCloud account and other Bluetooth devices you may have connected earlier. Under Apps, you will see the apps on the Apple TV. Then you have the Music app with its settings. Under Network, you will see the Wi-Fi or Ethernet connections with details. System gives you info and maintenance, in which you can check for software updates, reset and restart. Under AirPlay, you can mirror your iOS device or Mac. Let me mirror my iPad and show you. In Settings, General, you will see Screen Saver and you can even see the preview of it. You can check out the Plex app. You can see your pictures stored in your iCloud account. And then you can view and play your music library right from the Apple TV. Finally, the conclusion. Is it worth buying? Well, if you're in the Apple ecosystem and you don't have a smart TV or have a toned down version of one, then yes. It will sync your music, movies, photos stored in the iCloud automatically. You can mirror your iOS devices, Mac, etc. even during presentations. In India, I bought this unit for around 18,000 rupees for the 64 gig version. But if you're in the Android space and wish to remain in one, then the best TV box is the Nvidia Shield TV or Roku in case you are not in India. But the day Apple makes a complete TV set of its own, then it will be a completely different ballgame. So this is the end of this review. If you enjoyed this video, then do hit the thumbs up button and let me know what you think of TV streaming boxes in the comment section below. Check out my other videos of this channel, and if you like them, do hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified for future video uploads. With that, this is Kalyan Kumar signing off. Have a wonderful day. Goodbye. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.